Well, Sally's birthday is actually on the 25th of December, but we don't think it's right that she gets more than her sister does on Christmas Day, do we?
No.
No, but it was her 10th and she always used to like soft toys, so we got her one of those custom-made teddy bears from the Make a Mammal workshop.
Paid for every extra, made it smell like bananas when you smell it, everything.
Yes, and when you go in there, they let
you... Don't smell like bananas anymore though, does it? It smells like something...
Well, no one's going to be able to smell it on the television, are they? So it's not a necessary detail.
Waste of fucking money.
Anyway, when you go in, they give you hearts to stuff right inside the bear's chest yourself, with your fingers. There's no blood, though, is there?
Not when they do it, no.
No, and they give the hearts to all the kids that come in, and they... What do they say to them? Rub it on your heart so it loves you. Rub it on your knee so it needs you. Rub it on your eyes so it cries when you're not there.
They put a lot of thought into the wordplay.
Yes, and you can buy these special hearts with a little button inside them. So when you give the bear a squeeze, the heart actually beats inside the bear's chest, like a real one, for what, 15 seconds or so? It's a cute idea.
In theory, yeah. But...
So on Christmas Day, we gave Dostoevsky to Sally.
We paid for it, so we got to name it.
We wanted to try and encourage her to read proper books when she grows up. We could have called it Dogstoevsky if we got her a dog one.
I don't think they want other people to do the wordplay.
Which is fair enough, they're good at it.
She can't be trusted with dogs anyway.
No, not anymore. So, Sally gave the teddy bear a great big Christmas Day cuddle and she could feel its heart beating inside its chest. You should have seen her face light up. It was a picture, wasn't it?
Should have taken a picture. Back when she was okay in the head.
And then she says, Mummy.
Why is his heart stop beating?
Well, Sally, if you want his heart to keep beating, you have to give him a great big cuddle.
And the thing is, we didn't really think she'd feel quite so responsible for keeping the bear not dead.
She didn't sleep that night.
No, she just kept hugging him and hugging him and telling him everything was going to be fine. We didn't think anything was wrong at first. We just thought she really liked hugging it. In hindsight.
She didn't want to go to prison for murder.
No, so after 78 hours or so, she just conked out. God bless her soul.
I'm sure she has a soul anymore.
No, by the time she woke up...
Not sure there's a god.
Well,
either.
She must have worn the battery out or the button got stuck because the heart just wasn't beating anymore. And, well, we didn't expect her to try quite so hard to bring Dostoevsky back to life.
Didn't expect a lot of things.
Every time she asked us to take her down to the butcher's on a Saturday morning, we told her the same thing.
Real organs won't bring it back to life.
But we didn't want to discourage her from being interested in science. It was making her read proper books, which is what we wanted in the first place. So we said she could use the basement.
We wouldn't let her have it upstairs, not with how soggy it got.
He got.
Sally, I told you not in the kitchen. So, every day after school, she'd rush straight downstairs and with her doctor's books and put her little costume on and do her best to resuscitate the teddy bear.
We're not sure when she decided that conventional science wasn't enough, or, to be honest, actually, how she even knew about the occult in the first place.
Yes, she did start drawing runes on the basement walls with a hopscotch chalk just after term started. Looking back, we really should have been a bit more suspicious when she offered to take Rufus out for walkies.
She never did like that dog.
Her sister was devastated when she saw the body. There was so much blood. It was all smeared round her mouth like blood. We don't know how much she drank of it in the end, but Rufus's carcass was dry as a desert by the time.
We did think about punishing her, didn't we? But we thought the better parenting choice would be to make her undo the damage.
Yes, she's down in the basement now because when the ritual succeeded, which did take us all by surprise, full credit to her, we made a deal with her. If she could bring Rufus back to life, like she did for Dostoevsky, then we'll get rid of Dostoevsky.
Here he is. You have to give him a bit of a squeeze above the sink just before you pick him up to minimise all the dripping, but other than that...
Sally doesn't play with him anymore. This is exactly why she doesn't get double at Christmas.
He does wait outside the basement door for her, pawing at it again and again, a bit like a kitten drowning in a sack. It'd be cute if it wasn't
actually happening.
Well, Sally's back to not sleeping, for different reasons this time. He does love her, but, the feeling's not exactly mutual.
All that money we spent making it smell like fucking bananas.
He does love her. He does need her. He does cry when she's not there. Actually, it's more of a screech.
We haven't decided how we're going to put him down yet.
Not even sure if it's possible.
Rufus? Bill! But it's Rufus! She's done it! Sally's done it! I told you she'd manage!
Excuse us.